without mercy under two or three witnesses, how much more sore punishment suppose ye shall ye be thought worthy who hath trodden under the foot the Son of God? This is about rejecting Jesus Christ ultimately. And hath counted the blood of the covenant wherewith he was sanctified an unholy thing, and hath done despite unto the Spirit of grace. So I'm going to go ahead and end there, and we'll just end this out today with some prayer. Heavenly Father, we do come to you in prayer, and Lord God, I thank you for this time that you've given us, Lord, all your goodness and your mercy, Lord God. I do pray, God, for your fear to be upon the body of Christ, upon those unsaved, Lord God, upon our unsaved family members, Lord God, for you said in your word, it's your will that not one would perish, but that all would come to repentance. Lord God in heaven, I pray, Lord God, that through your fear, Lord God, you even said in your word that godly sorrow worketh repentance. Lord God, I pray to God you bring all these unsaved family members that we have, the people that will be saved, God, to salvation, Lord God, through godly sorrow. The Bible also says the goodness of the Lord leadeth thee to repentance, Lord God. But I believe most of the time godly sorrow has to come before the goodness, because godly sorrow will show us our sin in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, that what happened in Psalm 64, Lord God, what happened to the body of, what happened to the sin-sick world, Lord God, that all men would see and fear and declare the work of God, for they would wisely consider of your doing, that the righteous would be glad in the Lord and trust in you, and that all the upright in heart shall glory. I do pray, God, Lord God, that you would hide us under your wings, Lord God, under the covert of your wings would we make our refuge until these calamities be overpassed, as it says in your word, Lord God, because you're our only hope, moving into the times we're moving into. The shadow of your wings. But Lord God, I also know in your word it says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I pray to God that we would be dwelling in the secret place of the Most High, God. That we would be on our knees praying to you, Lord God, daily, seeking to appropriate this protection, moving into the times that we're moving into, Lord God, that you would use the body of Christ as light and salt, moving into the times we're living in, God. That they would look to us, God, that many would be saved as a result of what you're going to do with the people in this room, do with the people that are listening to this recording, and with the body of Christ. That many would be saved through what you're going to do through the body of Christ, God. That your name would be glorified through them, God. That you would guide us and direct us in all that we need to do in the coming times we're moving into, God. That we would not get depressed about these things, but we would look up, for we know that our redemption draweth nigh. Looking unto Jesus Christ, the author and finisher of our faith, I pray, God, we would keep our eyes fixed on Jesus. That we would be crucified with Christ according to Galatians 2:20. And we would not be afraid of what man would do unto us. And that, Lord God, we would fulfill Proverbs 28, verse 1, that says, the wicked flee when no man pursueth, but the righteous are bold as a lion. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray to God that would be our battle cry, moving in the times we're living into. That we would not be afraid of these things, God. And that, Lord God, you would give us the strength and the grace, and then it would be the Holy Spirit working through us. It would not be of our own self. It would not be of our own strength. It would be the Holy Spirit working through us in a mighty, mighty way to bring about these things, God. Not that we could glory in our flesh. Lord God, I also pray for your provision for the body of Christ, God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray to God for your provision, Lord God, moving in the times we're moving into, God. For if, God, we don't have the provision to move forward, God, our work for you will be hindered. And I'm praying this, Lord God, for the people in this room, for myself, for the body of Christ, God, that we would not so that we could live a life of luxury, God, and consume it upon our own lust, God, but we could have the provision to go forth and to bless others, God, to bless others, and that, Lord God, they could turn around and be a blessing to others, and that many would ultimately get saved as a result of these things, God. You did say in your word, Lord God, the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the righteous. In the name of Jesus Christ, I just pray that you bless everyone hearing this prayer, Lord God, during this time. I pray, Lord God, again for your fear to be upon us, Lord God, for your wisdom, for your knowledge, Lord God, for your understanding, God, that your angels would encamp around about us, God, that the blood of Jesus Christ would be upon us, that we would remember to put on the full armor of God every single day, that the Holy Spirit would go before us, Lord God, to do these things. That your divine protection will be upon us and even upon our families. And we love you, Lord God. We thank you for all these things. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Did you bring that thing to plug into the computer? Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. By darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. For I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood. Christ in me, from life's first cry